Esteban, the boatman on the Belize River ferry, whose 12-hour workday can include as many as 600 crossings, says cynically, "We haven't seen anything of the oil money." He, like a lot of Belizeans, predicts,
"Government is getting the benefit. Like we don't get no benefits from them."
In the recent past, the perception of corruption has been a significant issue.
And is there fire behind that smoke?
Well, that's a very good question. In the most recent municipal elections, the governing party lost control of all municipal bodies across the country, without exception. And I thought that was pretty telling.
This discovery of oil could bring tremendous future benefits to the people of Belize, but it's already bringing tremendous new responsibilities to the Belizean government, which must manage it.
The contract is actually a partnership between the government and the company. So all along, we were involved in all exploration work.
Andre Cho, the Belizean government's only geologist, has known for years about the potential for oil in Belize. But when it became a reality,
all of a sudden, a lot more work to do.
Andre Cho's workday suddenly went from 9 to 5 to 7 to midnight, or even later. Then he and the government took one of several steps that most observers have applauded. They asked for help.
Because we weren't ready for this, we need to get in the people that can assist us. And like I said, we've already taken steps to get in consultants who will provide technical assistance to us and guidance. And then eventually we'll get our own national staff so we can eventually take it over.
To many observers, the government passed a major test in late March, when Deputy Prime Minister John Briceño informed the Belizean legislature and the nation.
BNE indicates that the oil discovery in Spanish Lookout is of commercial quantity.
But he offered no further promises of future national wealth.
As I understood the budget presentation, the Prime Minister wanted to be cautious and conservative in his projections. And as a matter of fact, I understand that the new budget contains no revenue from oil.
Everybody associates the oil industry with large amounts of revenue. You know, and they're maybe inclined to overestimate what's available. I've seen a responsible attitude to that here with the government. Government are not counting their eggs before they've hatched.
Belize Natural Energy has been aggressively transparent about its dealings with government, making public all the basic details.
Long-term on the production of oil, the government benefited in three ways. Firstly, from a royalty payment, which is 7.5%. Secondly, from production share, which is a scale of 1.5% to 5% based on the amount of production that's available. And they also have a 10% buy-in on the company on the day that we declared formal production and commerciality of the field. This should net the government 38% of the gross revenues of all oil sales.
By opening its books on government oil revenues, BNE is actually helping the government stay honest, by helping voters and journalists track the expected oil benefits. Also on the benefits list, Belize's industrial moneymakers, its tourist hotels, its banana and citrus farms, its shrimp and fish farms, and eventually, the oil wealth should reach the boatmen of the Belize River ferry.
20 years ago, Belize was a what you may call a backwater, and nothing much happening, a couple of paved roads, no tourists basically, nobody knew about Belize. And there have been a tremendous amount of development that took place over the last 20 years. And the energy needs of the country have been skyrocketing. So because of the cost of fuels, particularly electricity, on the world market, finding a domestic source of energy could have a great effect on the economy, because whether you're a farmer or a shrimp farmer or a tourist operator, you know, the cost of diesel and gasoline is a big part of your cost of operation.
Andre Cho can see that future, where Spanish Lookout oil production covers all of Belize's national energy needs.
The next step would to determine if the field is large enough.
Step by step, he can see it all developing, with hundreds of jobs, millions in revenues being created. But he also knows this.
All that is premature right now.
I'm Dave Marash, Al Jazeera, Spanish Lookout, Belize.